Roy McDonald, philosopher, poet, wizard. Born June 4th, 1937 in London, Ontario, Canada. A well-known and recognized icon of the city. An accomplished writer and a poet. A man who dedicated his life to helping bring more love and magic back into the world. Roy spent many of his years traveling the streets of London as a busker and social alchemist.
I'm sure that I could be a movie star. I could ever get out of...
Known locally as the Mayor of Richmond Row, he would spend much of his time singing, sharing poetry, connecting others in the community who were curious enough to come up and meet this mysterious man.
I'm a busker, or also known as a street entertainer. I entertain on the street. I like people, I like singing, I sing on the street, and I also do poetry reciting on the street. I like the idea of bringing poetry to the people, bringing poetry to people that won't go to readings, poetry readings, because they think it's a sissy thing or whatever.
Through it all, thousands of times, I have lost and found myself.
Making money, there's some money to be made in it, not a lot, but it certainly is a way of making money, and I love people, I love entertaining.
Notable features of Roy included his iconic beard, which he grew his entire life. He commonly wore jackets covered in buttons, had pants often held together by duct tape, and always carried around what were seemingly grocery bags filled with journals, books, writings, and other collections to share with people. Roy lived his life as a vagabond, who willingly challenged us to look at our own preconceived notions of judging a book by its cover.
Yeah, I don't mind people thinking I'm poor, I'm homeless, whatever. I'm not, but I'm interested in how people treat people, like they think are homeless or think they're treated.
I like to make people happy. I like to get people to enjoy themselves and make people feel better on the street. I also consider myself, in a way, a social worker out here. There's a lot of lonely, sad people. A lot of kids, a lot of runaway kids. Some people that equate buskers to say, oh, you know, why don't you get a job? Get a job. Well, this is a job. Busking is a job.
In conversation, Roy was keen to share and discuss many topics that were of interest to him, such as philosophy, metaphysics, spirituality, consciousness, dreams, life beyond death, activism, social justice, and the power of art to help transform the world.
See a world in a grain of sand, and a heaven in a wild flower. Hold infinity in the palm of your hand, and eternity in an hour.
That's great. That's perfect.
Those who were fortunate enough to meet Roy were greeted with sincere generosity and the gift of his presence in any moment you spent with him. As for myself, my name is Brendon. I met Roy sometime back in 2010. Roy and I had several things in common. I had begun a local open-minded discussion and meditation group called Paradigm Shift London. I spend a fair amount of time doing free hugs and sharing shift buttons around the city as one of many ways to connect with community and help shift consciousness, often referring to myself and others who do so as shifters, which is exactly what Roy was too. Roy was a big supporter of the idea, and we would cross paths many times, even as my mystic Spider-Man version of myself. We would often talk about the nature of consciousness, and I would commonly give him some shift buttons as he happily wore and would pass on to others who he met along the way. To me, Roy was more than just a friend. He was an archetype within the dream. I saw him very much as a wizard and Merlin character, an urban shaman as he calls himself.
I consider myself to be an urban neo-shaman. And shamans are shape-shifters. I try to be as loyal as I can to my friends, to people, to the city, to the world, to the universe, realizing we are all one and one together with one another and with the whole universe.
Awesome. Thank you, Roy.
Cool. Another thing Roy commonly did was he shared special polished crystal stones to give to people who he met as keepsakes of his friendship and much more. In retrospect, even though I have filmed him a bunch over the years, I still wish I had filmed him more.
Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight. For we're all in the mood for a melody. We've got us.
Which way is seats?
But all those moments spent off camera, I know that they were important too. and each one still recorded within my heart. Roy inspired me countlessly to do what I can to help make a difference. And that's what I'm doing, simply by making this and sharing his story.
And to me, each day is a voyage of discovery and an exciting adventure. I just love life, I love people, and I'm perfectly happy doing what I'm doing right now, every day.
As we do the outer work in society, whatever we do, we need to be aware that the importance of the inner work, working on oneself. I'm a researcher, but I'm also an in-searcher, to be aware of your intuition. We all have intuition. I believe we are all psychic, although most of us have not developed our psychic abilities.
Roy helped change the world through one interaction at a time. Every person who met him had their mind and heart open just a little bit more. It showed us that we could follow our hearts. He was gently helping people wake up within the dream. Roy lived his life as his art, and the streets were his canvas.
I don't have much in terms of material possessions, but certainly what I have, I'm grateful for. And more than that, I'm grateful for the people I have, my friends and family.
Roy had many accomplishments throughout his life, including two official publications. First in 1970 was his book, The Answer Question, a bizarre pun-based poem that spanned the entire read.
The Answer Question, taboo or not taboo? That is not the question. Taboo or not taboo? Is that the question? To be, B-E-E, or not to be? That is only the question for a bumbling bee who believes his hive to simply be in the flower of his youth.
And of course, his other well-known book, Living, a London Journal, which documents his raw experience over the course of 7 days in London and gives an intimate look into his perception of the world. Roy would often share stories about all the famous people he has met over the years. He has stories of being at the original Woodstock, where he would tell you that he spent most of his time looking for a girl, the same girl from one of his more commonly shared poems.
With your touch, I know my body, which is the diamond body of the Buddha, my Eve, my beloved mate, lost and found forever. Thank you.
With all the connections Roy had, he quite literally was a walking encyclopedia of what London was. Amidst all the information Roy had to share, his past has always been a bit of a mystery, something only a few people know the full details of. Many wondered if he had a home, and he did. He lived in the house he grew up in on Wellington, within which he would spend his time writing on the walls, literally.
I've written notes on the walls of my house, on notes, ideas, thoughts, philosophies, on the walls of my house, and on the walls outside too, and on the doors, and on the garage I've written, and on the tree, on some of the trees, which is really eccentric, of course, naturally. But it works for me. I do it for a specific purpose, because I like being surrounded by writings, by literature, by some of these are quotes, some from my favorite poets.
Yet body is vehicle or instrument, mode of expression for soul, mind on earth, need to love, respect.
Though amidst the mystery, it is no secret that Roy's journey included him overcoming his alcoholism in episodes of depression. During his youth, Roy was introduced to transcendental meditation. Methods he learned from this practice, along with regular daily affirmations, helped Roy maintain his will over the years. The last time he drank was in 1975. Over the years, many people have paid their own tributes to Roy in a plethora of fashions, paintings, sculptures, and books, and a notable one being the book Pocket Man, which is more or less a character in a story based on Roy's adventures in Montreal during the 70s. Also, Roy had a stage play made of him called Beard, which was written by Jason Ripp and performed twice in London over the years.
This is a show about a life, my life. I am a play. I'm written on street corners, I'm written all over the town that you call home. And if you don't know me, you can definitely get to know me. I'm not hard to find.
This is where they're holding Beard, A Few Moments in the Life of Roy McDonald. It's delightful for me.
I never saw the play myself, unfortunately, though I heard many great things about it. Notably, like how at the end, Roy would come on stage and sing I Did It My Way with the actor playing him.
The record shows I took the blows and did it my way.
Another notable tale told many times is when Roy was kicked off the University of Western Ontario campus by security, unknown that he was a published author who had books in the university's library. Following the event, he immediately contacted the Free Press, who wrote about the injustice. The next day, UWO formally apologized. Roy would commonly share this story, quite adamantly, due to its novelty and pride.
I marched with Martin Luther King against the war in Vietnam in 1966. Montreal, Toronto, New York, Washington. Just all over the place.
Question authority. Question authority. Question authority. Question authority. Always question authority.
Oh, well, my hands are shaking and my knees are weak. Can't seem to stand on my own 2 feet. Who do you think of when you have such luck? I'm in love. I'm all shook up.
I have my freedom. I can spend all day, every day, doing exactly what I love to do. And very few people can say that.
One of the things I'm interested in is death and dying. Of course, there's the concept that we're all dreaming. This whole thing is a dream. The importance of dream and the dream life. And certainly what happens in dreams is magic in many, many ways.
In the heart of everything is silence. And in the deepest heart of our being is this silence, which is the silence, the mystery of being.
I still have dreams of close friends of mine that have died many years ago. In our dreams, they're not dead. They're alive, and we're talking to them, and they're talking. And I'm interested in dreams to the point where I try to write down my dreams, or write down a little bit about my dreams anyway, each day, and to pay attention to our dream life.
I guess I've always lived sort of on the fringes of the cult, on the fringes of society, or I've been marginalized or on the margins of society. And that's fine. That's okay. That's, you know, I can be happy with that.
Roy was many different things to many different people.
So much more energetic than most people I know at his age, and he's such a lovely, lovely person, and he's just wonderful, and I love knowing him, and I love being close to him.
If you see something wrong, help to make it right. Draw a shadowed world into the bright sunlight. Bring us all good luck. Let the good guys win.
We love you, Roy.
Roy, you're a good friend. You're a sainted philosopher. I wouldn't know what to do without you at the Philosopher's at Cafe every month at the library. So keep on doing what you're doing, no matter what anybody tells you.
A lot of people are locked into a routine, a system, whereas Roy has been fortunate enough and maybe intelligent enough to decide for himself what he wants to do and how he wants to live, and I admire that.
Don't ask me what's on my mind. I'm a little mixed up, but I'm feeling fine.
This man right here, Roy McDonald, is one of the charitable staples of the city. I think there should be a monument, a bronze statue of Roy erected near Jim Bob Ray's Joe Cool's to commemorate this man's life for all of four city eternities.
Life itself is a gift, a valuable gift that none of us did anything to earn. So count your blessings, be grateful, and peace be with you.
And who do we have here?
This is my favorite cousin.
I just trimmed my beard this week, actually.
There was hardly a day that went by where Roy wasn't meeting someone new, supporting a local artist, or just helping bring good vibes to the city simply by being himself. His story spans countless individual experiences over the years. He was always there, just waiting for you to run into him again. Although, in February 2018, people around London began to notice that Roy had not been seen as much lately. Many began to worry, as it was frequent for him to visit his favorite coffee shops. In the midst of a cold winter, many feared the worst. On February 21st, word begins to spread about Roy's passing. Roy had passed in his sleep, peacefully, at his home. I was first told about it by my partner at the time. Serendipitously enough, her and I met through Roy when he had introduced us to each other at the recent Psychic Expo. This was the last time that either of us saw him. Outpourings of comments began coming forward all across the internet. Roy's cousin Julie was quick to champion a Facebook group for everyone to reflect through. Roy knew everyone. I remember the feeling of that day well. Because at the same time, there was an incredible flooding happening in the city. It's like there was a big emotional collective release that was taking place through all of us. Grief is very personal. For me, Roy's passing was a very sad and yet happy thing, because it was another important step on his journey as a soul. Plus, the fact that he passed away in his sleep was very fitting. Funny enough, one of the first things I did that day following the news of his passing was create a digital interactive version of him using an app that I had synchronistically just discovered the night before. Simply being able to laugh at the novelty of it and just being able to keep a version of Roy in my own pocket. And besides, maybe someday we will be able to simulate a Roy AI consciousness to interact with. I checked with his cousin Julie and she agrees that Roy would love this idea. In the days following his passing, I wrote a poem about Roy, which I read in the same spot that he had shared his poetry at a local poetry meetup.
With a long white beard and a twinkle in his eyes, with his gaze to the heavens and his hands held out, asking, why? Why do we judge before we read? Why do we sleep before we wake? Why must we hide our favorite song when we can sing it for all the world to take?
After posting the video of it, Julie asked me to read the poem at his funeral. I could not have been more honored. On the day of the funeral, I chose not to bring my own camera, instead just focusing on being present.
And it's hard to imagine life in London without him. He was always everywhere. And I know that he's here with us today, and he's loving every minute of this.
His funeral was a joyous recollection of the man Roy is, and so reading the poem that I wrote about him was incredibly meaningful. Afterwards, several came up and thanked me for it. As we left, people signed his casket, leaving a variety of lasting messages for him. I had never taken a selfie at a burial before, but for Roy, it made sense. In the days following Roy's death, I was still learning more and more about him, as if I was beginning to see deeper into his own perception of the world, why he did what he did, and the impact it had.
Be kind to all of those who you encounter, for everyone is carrying a heavy burden, including yourself. Be kind to yourself.
Not long after his funeral, hundreds gathered again for his celebration of life, which we did in the Market Garden, one of Roy's favorite spots, to share stories, poems, and songs for our friend Roy.
My lords and ladies, welcome to a celebration of the life of Roy McDonald!
I think this is important for us all in this time of missing him, is he would say, if I died today, I would die fulfilled. He said that to me on many occasions. And I think that's a real testament. I always say Roy had a wealth of friends, which is true wealth.
We will surely, surely miss you, but you are still so much a presence here and all over our Forest City and will be forever.
You are the great connector. You are the great maitre d' of the planet. Roy McDonald, we salute you and we'll think of you every day of our lives.
Roy, still bringing people together and mending, yeah, and bringing love.
Thank you, Roy, from your favorite cousin, for being so warm and friendly, giving the best hugs, introducing me to so many fascinating and interesting people in London, Ontario, a city that you loved so dearly. You are still with us in spirit, and I'm sure that we're going to continue to celebrate you for a very long time. Love you, Julie.
In addition to making Roy buttons, the obvious decision was quickly made to begin accepting donations for a Roy statue fund, to eventually put a bronze statue of him downtown that would commemorate his legacy for the centuries to come. Something that you too can contribute to.
He was always showing me all these articles that had been written about him or plays that were being done about him, and he'd always say, did you see the piece that so-and-so wrote about me? A good friend of mine, did you see? Here, you can have this. He had like sort of an endless supply of photocopies he would hand out to people. Seems like there's a Roy-shaped hole in the city now. Every time I go downtown or drive past Joe Cool's on Richmond Row, I'm expecting him to walk back out again. But the one thing we can do is we can keep the spirit of Roy alive in this town. So anytime two people stop and have a conversation on Richmond Row, Roy is with them. Anytime you bend down to pet someone's dog at Sunfest, Roy is with you. You know, you stop and tell someone about an article you've written or a play you're directing or a concert you're playing, Roy is there with you. So here's a Roy McDonald, bohemian poet, unofficial mayor of Richmond Row, and a man I was more than proud to call my friend. Thank you.
Roy, when we're together we fly. We open up.
Thank you for your love, your patience, your wonderful knowledge, man. Like, I love listening to you, brother, man. Just know that. It's just awesome. It was great to know you. You always live in our hearts. Absolutely. Love you, Roy.
And with Roy's passing, it really gave me sort of a collateral moment to really reflect on death and what Roy meant to me. Dear fellow Herald of the Wind, gatekeeper of words, agent of Merlin, fill this air, I welcome thee.
Thank you, Roy, for all the times we've shared, our serendipitous encounters, the people you've introduced me to, the awesome stories you shared, and the love you shared.
I have been seen and reflected through your eyes to glimpse upon a sagely beacon. A myriad of your courtesies bestowed to all have outpoured into a legacy, rippling beyond the measure of your beard.
I'd also like to show off and be thankful for the stone you gave me in one of our encounters. I carry it with me wherever I go. Thanks, Roy.
Immortalized by memory, contained within the heart, the collapse of your matter will forever hold an infinite space.
As the man looks you in your third eye, you feel a wave roll over your heart. He speaks to you so softly. Your love is your art.
Thank you, Roy, for helping open my heart, to encourage me to continue to ripple the inspiration of love, to continue to spark the flame, to continue to remind people of how much potential they actually have to co-create within this dream.
If the doors of perception were cleansed, everything would appear to us as it is, infinite. One of my favorite quotes.
Exactly.
Roy serves as a sound reminder of how we ought, I seek to lead my life. Let's lift one another up, not tear one another down.
I know that I'm gonna channel my inner Roy wherever I go, and I'm sure everyone else will too. Lots of love.
Here we go.
Pocket man, oh pocket man, how much can you stand? Pocket man, oh pocket man, what is your plan?
I know the world wholly. Through your eyes, I see myself.
I sleep 12 hours a day. And I was like, Roy, what? How could you do that? How could you get anything done? But he was like, no, my dreams are so vivid. And I see the people that I've lost. And I see my mom and my dad. And I see all the friends that have gone. And I love that time, that half the day that I spent sleeping. So I think it's very fitting that Roy did pass in his sleep.
With your touch, I know my body, which is the diamond body of the Buddha.
Because you are your own creator, a dreamer within the dream, seeing beyond the illusions and remembering what has always been. So all the times that I'll be out there in the future doing free hugs, doing poetry on the street, I'll be thinking of you. Love you. Thank you. Because it continues with our story, forever inspired by a man named Roy. Like a true wizard, Roy helped change the world through the magic of love and showed us how to do the same.
Well, if you want to sing out, sing out. And if you want to be free, be free.
In the time following Roy's passing, people still gather in tradition around the date of his birthday on June 4th each year at the market. Roy's legacy continues to connect and strengthen us as a community. So thank you, Roy, our philosopher, our poet, and our wizard, for doing it your way and for helping show and inspire all of us to do it our way. From all of your friends, we love you forever. May you live on eternally, from one dream to the next.
Thank you very much. Find a new way.
You can do it today. You can make it all true. And you can make it undo. You see.
You're always an amazing, wonderful person, and we'll be missed in this wonderful community that we live in. Thank you for everything that you've done for this community.
You were a person of peace, and now may you rest in peace, Roy.
We keep our streets safe in Canada here, and your spirit will live on. God bless you.
Thank you for being the spark of the city for so many years. Thank you for inspiring and being a street sage to us all.
Thank you, Roy, for all of our great conversations together and for sharing just how you were and for reminding me about hope in the world and about that peace and love can keep going and friendship and being kind to each other continues on beyond wherever we could imagine. You
can do it. Roy, say hello to the people through the magics of the internet.
I say hello to people through the magic of the internet.
You did. You
anything more
did.
You want me to say?
No, that's it. Good job.
It's easy. Thank you, Roy. I hope you're sitting cross-legged in the clouds with Thoreau and Gandhi and Maurice Buck and talking about all the questions of the universe and finding the answer to why.
Page
69 of Living a London Journal by Roy McDonald, page 69. I thought of how this ties in with transcendental meditation, with its emphasis not only on individual well-being and fulfillment, but also on the harmony, orderliness, and well-being of society.
Came to celebrate your life, and we're so happy that you made such an impact on our community. We'll always remember you. You live on and on in our hearts. Mwah, 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 mwah. Love you, Roy.
And for really bringing people together and letting us share so many memories of you.
Thank you for your light legacy in this lifetime. And I hope you feel it in the next. Everything that you brought through. Thank you.
Thank you, Roy, for your friendship over the years and for bringing people together and for helping people reunite.
He gave me a stone so I don't feel alone, and now he is being revealed. La 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 la.
For blessing this world now and forever.
You always had a good story and you always had a smile, and I love you and miss you.
Some made money from a lifetime of savings, some just surname on a marble stone. It's not what you leave, it's the joy of remembering. All I can leave you is a bag full of bones.
So long, farewell to all these dreams that tease me so. Hello, mother, it's you I'm dreaming of. I'll have no
Roy McDonald can look into that mirror, hold his head high, and be very proud of the guy in the glass who's staring back at him.
And they were all standing there, the little kids, and they looked over, and there was this guy with a big long beard, and all the little kids were pointing and said, oh, look at him, look at him. And that guy with the beard came over and took my daughter's hands and said, hello, Laura. And all the little kids looked with amazement.
Thanks, Roy, for making all of this happen and bringing all of us together. I know a lot of you from a lot of places. Love you, man.
Touch the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000
I didn't care what was their crime, till their sorrow turned into mine. Till their sorrow turned into mine.
I wish I had a fearless heart like Roy. I think we all do, I really do. Sometimes we have to find it, but it's there. Thank you very much.
Yeah. All the people dreaming lives. I've always been a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. World will be as one, at the end of the world will be as one. And, yeah.
Pay attention to your dream life, and even try to, if you can, incubate your dreams. Intend to dream about a certain person or a certain topic or a certain problem, and when you get up in the morning, think of, lie in bed. Don't write down your dreams immediately. You'll forget them because you're going to consciousness. These dreams will disappear. Just lie in your bed. Don't move, and go over your dreams in your memory,
And then when you wake, you get fully awake, just jot them down, or jot down the titles of dreams and think of them off and on through the day. And this will enrich your life in every possible way, as it certainly has enriched mine.
That's beautiful. Thank you, Roy.
Okay. You're welcome. Thank you.
Dream on.